With the new XFL set to kick off in 2020, it is informative to look back at what marketed the first league, and there was no bigger selling point than letting the players have personalities. And there certainly wasn't a better personality than He Hate Me. Born Rod Smart on January 9, 1977 in Lakeland, Florida, he would spend his youth there and end up attending Lakeland High School, where he ran track and played both running back and cornerback for the football team. His high school accomplishments would allow Smart to play for the D1AA Western Kentucky football team, as well as run for the track team. Smart would receive only 7 carries in his 1996 freshman season, but would make the most of it, taking it for 69 yards. During his sophomore season, he would see his role greatly expanded, obtaining 496 yards and 3 touchdowns on 82 attempts, while also tallying an additional 4 yards on his sole reception. In 1998, he would see his role slightly reduced, falling back to the team's third back, though his production would remain remarkably consistent, picking up 491 yards and 8 touchdowns on 79 carries. He also pulled in 5 receptions for an additional 83 yards and a score, and even returned 1 punt for 14 yards. Hard work and persistence allowed Smart to jump up the depth chart and become the featured back heading into his senior year. During the season, he had 188 attempts for 1,249 yards and 10 touchdowns. He also caught 3 passes for 28 yards. Though he had a more than acceptable collegiate career, the lack of eye-popping statistics, as well as playing for a lower-level school, led to him going undrafted in the 2000 NFL Draft. That would not, however, mean he would not have an NFL opportunity, as he signed as an undrafted free agent to the San Diego Chargers. Unfortunately, he found himself released prior to the 2000 NFL season. Luck would be on Smart's side, though, because in the spring of 2001, a new league was starting, the XFL. He would sign with the Las Vegas Outlaws and would adopt the nickname He Hate Me for the first game of the season, with the original intention of changing it every week. But with the great reception of the name choice, he decided to keep it indefinitely. In 2004, when he was asked about the name choice, he stated, "Basically, my opponent is going to hate me. After I win, he's going to hate me. It is what it is. It's a saying I was saying when I'd feel something wasn't going my way. For example, when I was on the squad in Vegas and the coach was putting other guys in, if I felt I was better than them, you know what? Hey, he hate me. See what I'm saying? Give me a chance. That's all I ask. It comes from the heart, within. The way I felt, I feel as if everybody hates me. From my mom, to my dad, and even my brothers and sisters. Everyone hates me. My buddy Greg Cates always used to use it, so I took it from him." 2001 would be a productive enough year for Smart, as he finished second in the league behind only Chicago's John Avery, with 555 yards on 146 attempts and 3 touchdowns. In May 2001, the XFL ceased operation. And that was rather devastating for Smart, as he had fully committed to the ideas of the XFL, and really had no intention of using it as a platform to return the NFL, or even heading to Canada. But with the demise of the league, he had to change his plans. He initially signed with the Edmonton Eskimos of the CFL, playing 1 preseason game prior to being released in August 2001. He would stay a free agent until being signed to the Philadelphia Eagles practice squad on October 2nd. At some point during the season, he would be promoted to the 53-man roster, and would be active for 6 games, where he gained 6 yards on 2 carries. He'd be let go after the season, but would be claimed off waivers by the Carolina Panthers. He'd spend the majority of his professional football career there, from 2002 to 2005. In 2002, he'd be active for all 16 games, and would see almost all of his snaps on special teams, leading the team with 24 special teams tackles. He would also get a rush during the season, which he carried for 2 yards. In 2003, he would see his role expanded, as he began to return kicks along with his kick coverage. Over the season, he would return 41 kicks for 947 yards, and even had a 100-yard kick return for a touchdown. He also played second on the team with 14 special team tackles, and even had a blocked punt. In addition to seeing kick returns, he also had his role in the backfield expanded, where he saw 20 rushes for 49 yards and 3 receptions for 11. In the postseason, he would help the Panthers get all the way to Super Bowl 38, with 285 kick return yards on 12 returns, with 74 of those yards coming on 4 returns in the Super Bowl. Smart's 2004 season would be cut short by injury. He appeared in the first 3 games of the season, prior to being placed on IR with a knee injury. In those 3 games, he had 169 kick return yards on 8 returns, and 9 offensive yards on 4 touches. In 2005, he would return to the Panthers healthy, but would see his role reduced, only appearing in 12 games, where he returned 29 kicks for 615 yards, and recorded only 9 special team tackles, along with a fumble recovery. He would be released after the season, but would sign with the Oakland Raiders on May 4th, but he would spend part of the preseason injured and would fail to make the 53-man roster, and this is where his professional career seemingly ended. But on January 26, 2008, Smart was selected by Team Tennessee during the inaugural draft of the All-American Football League. But unfortunately, this new league, unlike the XFL, did not help Smart, as it postponed its inaugural season, releasing him from his contract, and his career ended once again, this time for good. After football, as many professional athletes would, he went into personal training, with his own company, SmartSize. In 2010, he also tried his hand at acting, appearing in the film Don't Blame the Lettuce, and is now also a high school guidance counselor in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Howdy y'all, Jackson here with Dick Jerk Studios, and I hope you enjoyed that episode of Football History. And if you did, please consider leaving a like, and if you have a player, coach, or event you would like to see me do a video on, please leave it in the comment section below. And if you are new here, and like the content, please hit that subscription button, and feel free to look around at other videos in my catalog. Bye!